What's going on? Just wanted to pop in here and talk about an interesting video I just watched. And y'all, yeah, I'm on it. For those of y'all don't like me talking about the whole title and stuff, they just click off this video. Don't even watch. Anyway, I'm doing this as a response so y'all can check out the video. And y'all also check out, her screen name is Being Me Regardless. I'm going to put her thing on here. But again, this is a response. Show some love, subscribe. She have sense. Yeah, she was talking about, the question is, why is it so hard to date an aggressive femme? Me, I've said it before, I like aggressive females. And it has nothing to do with a title. I like a woman who has her own mind. Is there something wrong with that? My whole, you know, okay, let's bring it into the titles because that's what she's speaking about. So that's what I'm going to respond to. I think that studs have a problem dating aggressive women because they're trying to take on the roles of heterosexual relationships. And if you look at heterosexual relationships, in my experience, I know some women that in a hetero man and woman, the woman is more aggressive than the man. That doesn't take away from him being a man. That just happens to be the woman's personality. You feel me? What you think? Because my whole thing is like, why is it so much a thing where it has to be, like she said in her video, in her experience, you know, she was saying how when, you know, someone she was with would say, oh, you're trying to take my position, and da, da, da. Why does that take away from you? I honestly think it's that, we're using the titles, I think it's that studs. Lack of confidence? Y'all feel where I'm going. I think it's a studs issue. It ain't got nothing to do with that other person because why, you know, if you know who you are, you know what you can handle, what you can't, why does it matter if you're dealing with someone who's just a little bit more aggressive than you? Why does it matter?
Why do labels matter in the first place?
Would
you call, if you're looking at a heterosexual relationship, a regular male and female, would you be calling the male aggressive?
It's assumed that, you know, a male is aggressive.
But you wouldn't call him an aggressive
because
male.
Because it's already assumed. Because he's a man.
So, what does that say about
it? But it's assumed. That's what they would say. Because, you know, boys are raised to be tough and girls are, But it's kind of dumb because if it's two women dealing with two women, then y'all both supposed to be, You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? That's what it's supposed to be. So it's like, I mean, I've been in situations, you know, where that word comes up, you know, playing a position, all the stuff. Really does, I mean, why does it really have to be a position? Why you can't just be? Just be.
Look at it. Like, why the labels? So what are you going to call a man who doesn't make as much money as the wife, stays at home with the kids, takes care of the kids because the wife may be, you know, a high power attorney or whatever you want to call it, who puts in them a lot of hours. So what, he's a sissy man just because he's taking care of his children?
It used to be seen as that, but no more.
Exactly.
No more.
Labels change.
Right.
So why?
It doesn't
why
change.
Start with labeling. But why label? Or two partners, whatever sex they are, what difference does it make how they are as long as they're good together? Some of them might be more aggressive in one area in life, and others might be more aggressive in another. Somebody might be docile during the regular life, during work and stuff, and might be completely insane in bed.
Yeah.
But how would you label them? Why label them at all? If a couple works together, they either work or they don't, just like any relationship. It's the personalities that matter, not the labels. Some personalities clash, otherwise mix well together. It makes no difference what they call themselves as long as it works.
But it's not really seen like that. I mean, not for everybody. I mean, there are very few like myself who don't want anything to do with labels. And, you know, even looked on like, yeah, okay, whatever. No. If, like you said, if it works, it works. If it... Because, yeah, I said it. I would date someone that looked like me. We both women. So what? One of us is going to be more aggressive than the other. If it works, it works.
But think about it this way. The minute you start labeling somebody and the minute you decide that you like somebody with such and such label, that means you're missing out on other people that might label themselves differently but might actually work with you.
Right. I agree. You miss out on, you got to get to know people. You can't, this is why I say with the labels, I believe labels just have to do with what is in bed. And even with that, it's kind of off as well. Because again, let's talk about this, staying with the stud business. You have so much different kind of studs. You have a touch me not stud. You have a touch me not stud is a, sorry, she's straight. She don't know what the hell I'm talking about. A touch me not stud is a stud, a masculine woman that doesn't like to be touched. She want to do all the pleasing. She
okay.
don't want no kind of
okay.
nothing going on.
Got it.
Then you have some that you can touch above the belt. Then you, it's a whole bunch of shit. So it's like,
but it's all personal. Again, it's why label something? It's something that you like. Why should there be a label? Why should there be a classification where something falls into one and something falls into another? Sex is sex. Sex, good sex is messy and all over the place. Why label it?
I say it's basically what you like. It's like what you like and what you don't like. You're right. You can't really put a label on it. Because, okay, as you say, heterosexual. So, okay, if you don't like certain things, what you... Does your husband call you something?
Does that mean
it? Yeah. What your husband call you? What does he say?
But that's the thing. In a heterosexual relationship, almost never regarding that end, unless it's specifying like S&M or DSM or whatever, DS or...
Sound like shoe stores.
Yeah. No, I mean, unless there are certain kinks that are specified within a particular category, there's no labeling going on.
It's just like whatever.
A female is a female, a male is a male, whether the female is a little bit more genteel or not, they usually don't specify that and they usually don't categorize that. So why all of a sudden that since it's the same sex couple, all of a sudden there has to be some kind of label, there has to be a box where you stuff yourself in? Why should sexuality have a box in the first place? Everybody likes different things. Everybody likes what they like. So what? Just because you like one thing, that means you can't like something completely different.
Once you put this label on, everything is within this. You
exactly.
can't do this. You can't do
you
that.
You put shutters on. You know, like, the way I picture it is like, you know, the horse with the shutters on? They only see what's in front of them. They cannot see sideways. But the problem is that once you put labels down and you start going, well, I don't like that kind of a label. Therefore, you're missing out on people. But again, you never know. Just because they label themselves, and again, there's no classification. You can label yourself whatever the hell you want. But it doesn't mean you fit into the exact same label as somebody else is labeling them.
So then it comes, but then that, you know, with that, then there's
you
a whole.
You can't quantify.
I'm just a woman who loves women. Sorry.
You can't quantify it. It's not mathematics where no matter what you add, it comes out to the same thing.
Not at all. Well, thanks for listening. We're about to close this one. We're going to be going on 8 minutes. All right, y'all. Peace, y'all.